Hi, welcome to Tigers TV. It's today, Telford Tigers take on the Basingstoke Bison. Before we go and take a look at today's action, let's catch up with player coach Tom Watkins. Tom, looking ahead to today's game, what are you expecting?
Hopefully a good start and a lead going into the end of the first period. We always set a goal, and obviously that's an important goal. We don't want to be behind, we don't want to be playing catch up. Goals are hard to come by at the minute, so taking a lead and playing with a lead would be good.
And after last night's performance, again, it seemed like a good performance for the majority of the game and then just a lapse in concentration and maybe some nerves. So what are you saying to the guys to kind of try and combat that?
I think if we actually take our scoring opportunities, we don't put ourselves in those situations. We give up a goal, we give up two, it's 2-1, and I don't know if guys get nervous, if guys feel they've got to do something different. If we stick to our system, we'll be fine. Even at 2-1, we're still in the hockey game, there's still a long way to go, but to give up three goals in a short space of time, really frustrating. But the guys have got to man up, they've got to play like men, and they've got to react accordingly to each situation.
Thank you.
now by Red Touch Media's Wayne Scholes, CEO. Wayne, your first home game since Red Touch got involved with the club. How are you feeling? Looking forward to the game?
I'm actually more excited than I can tell you, because the last time I was here was probably 20 years ago, and of course the ice rink looked very, very different back then, and the Tigers looked a little different back then. So for me personally, it's a great thing to be back in the rink, a great thing to be back in Telford. It's, you know, it's where I was born, so I'm really excited for the game tonight.
Fantastic. And going back all that time ago, 20 years ago, and we've heard lots of stories about you being the stick boy and kind of being involved with the club then, and I know kind of Andy Plant, who was involved back then, has told us a few stories and stuff. So it's good to have you back on board. And what are you looking forward to most with Red Touch getting involved?
You know, that was the part that I was worried about, that you might have heard some of the stories. Back then, hockey was very different, so I had a shaved head one time too. But there's a, you know, there's a great feeling for me to be back here because of my history with the club. As you say, I was a stick boy when I was 15, 16, and so, you know, there is a great passion for me internally about the club and about ice hockey here. And being able to be a part of that growth and being able to support the club made it very easy for me to make a decision. It wasn't a tough decision to make. I sat down and we looked at it as a company and said, you know, look, do we have a real product that we are going to use in the UK? And the truth is, we don't really have a real product base here. Our business is in the film industry. We manage content for film studios. That's what we do. However, you know, the emotional side of it is that I really like ice hockey and I really like what Telford Tigers are trying to do. And as a company, you know, we're the same as any other company out there. We've been through hard times, and I know Telford have been through some hard times, and they've come out of it fighting. So it wasn't a hard decision to get back involved with the Telford Tigers.
And then moving forward, kind of with a big sponsor such as yourself coming on board, it's raised expectations certainly amongst the supporters and stuff. And, you know, we've got a good squad and looking to be kind of a faster, more physical team. Moving forward, you know, what kind of things are you expecting to kind of see from the team, I guess?
Well, look, for me, I'm very much a sports fan. I've always been a sports fan, and so I try very hard not to have an opinion about the sports we get involved in, because I think the coach deserves the opportunity to be supported by the fans, supported by the sponsors, and really have the opportunity to just create what they see as their vision. And that's where I see our biggest role for Red Touch Media, is being able to provide the resources for the coach to do what they want. And I very much believe in Tom as a coach. So it's very exciting to be able to be a supporter of that. And that, look, that doesn't mean there aren't going to be times where I'm not disappointed. I mean, I was sitting in LA last week, you know, getting text message updates on the score, and I was freaking out, and I was in the middle of a meeting. But, you know, I'm always going to be disappointed if we lose, of course, because I'm a fan. But I have great expectations for the team, because I think once the resources are in place for the team, I think Tom will be able to create something very special here in Telford. And I think in a year's time, we're going to be looking back on this with a very different view.
Bison returns at full strength.
Oh!
number 15 for the Bison, number 14 for the 34 for the Tigers, 2 minutes for the Rocking, time to time, 3-9-3-6. Take a trip to the parking of the penalty room. Thank you. Bison returns to full strength.
Joined now by Tiger sponsor Gareth Price from GTS Couriers and his son Harry. Gareth, like 3-2 loss, but how did you enjoy the game?
Yeah, good game. We could take our chances in front of the net. We'd hopefully, you know, we'll do a bit better, but time will tell. So if the forwards, you know, can find the gear, then hopefully that'll be okay.
And you've been sponsoring Tigers for a few years now. Tell us about what GTS does.
Yeah, it's a courier company based in Worcester. So I didn't do it to get any work or business out of this Telford area, but I just did it just to help the team, and I love ice hockey in Telford. So, you know, a few quid can help them.
Fantastic. And you're here week in, week out. What do you think, Harry? Enjoy it?
Yeah.
I think it's probably a great game to watch from upstairs, and fortunately for the Tigers fans, we didn't pick up the 2 points. I thought we played really well. We were pretty stubborn in what we were doing. Our forecheck was good. We turned pucks over and we made opportunities. But at the minute, our problem is that we're making the opportunities and we're not converting them, and you're always leaving yourself open for something at the other end of the ice. But no, I thought the guys played well. They played hard. Basingstoke's a stacked unit. You know, they've got three lines that can play at a high level and a high pace, and I thought we really pushed them really hard. And I think, to be honest, I think we should have won the game, and I don't often say that, but I do think we should have probably come out with the points tonight.
Like you said, we've talked previously about kind of being more clinical and finishing off chances, and again, a lot of chances, and yet another netminder who gets man of the match.
Well, yeah, maybe that's us. Maybe we're shooting pucks at guys, and when we're pulling, we're not got our heads up, we're not looking, and a couple greasy rebounds wouldn't go amiss, or a couple of shots from the point that take a double deflection and go through a guy's legs, and sometimes when it's not going for you, it just won't go. So guys have got to relax around the front of the net. They've got to be not patient, because you've got to get pucks off your stick nice and quick, but they've got to make sure that they're looking and they're firing into corners and away from goalies' pads. And we said to the guys before the game, you know, he's not great in tight. He goes down very low, very quick, and Bally's second goal straight up over the shoulder. But we had a lot of chances in tight, and I think if we got pucks up, we probably would have scored a few more.
But it looks like the lines are starting to gel a bit more, and kind of knowing where each other are going to be and reading the passes a bit better.
Well, we changed things around a little bit tonight. We moved Mika to the middle with Scott and somebody else. I can't remember who it was now. But I thought Mika played a great game. He was good. He's defensively very strong. He's good on the puck. He skates real well, and he works very hard. And from a centreman's point of view, I think he had a good contribution. And I thought he worked well with Scott and McCauley. That was the guy who I forgot. And you know what? McCauley had a great game. He's 17 years old, and he could have scored a couple of goals tonight. And he put in a couple of good hits, and he won't back down from anybody, which is great to see from a young player.